Hey guys, it's Patrick with Uncle Bill's Camping. Today we're going to be talking about this right here. This is the Covia Soul Gas Lantern. It's a neat little lantern from Korea and something that you really don't see that much of over here at the camping stores. I picked it up. Anyway, I'm going to tell you about it. Hang around for a minute. Alright guys, so just like I said in the introduction, we're talking about the Covia Soul Gas Lantern. And Covia is a company that's kind of odd in the fact that they you really don't find them in the United States. And it doesn't seem like they have too much of an interest in advertising their products or selling them over here. But it does seem that they make really great products. So I was Googling lanterns the other day and come across this and had to go to their website and kind of look at it. And they definitely seem to market more toward the hiking gear community. But this is, to me, not really a piece of hiking gear. It is a strange hybrid that sits somewhere in between car camping and hiking, strictly due to its size. It has all the characteristics of hiking gear. It runs on a butane cartridge. It has that nice metal frame around it. It's not that big, but it's a little too big to be hiking gear. But if you were to say car camping gear, it's definitely a lot smaller. If you were to set it next to, say, a Coleman dual fuel lantern or a propane lantern that runs off of the 1 pound green propane bottles, then it would definitely be very, very small. It also comes in this pretty big case right here. Now it is a protective case, granted, and there's some moldings on the inside of it to where once it sits down in there, it's not going to rattle around and the glass itself isn't going to get broken. But all in all, it's hard to classify it as hiking gear because, like I said, if you were to compare this to, say, camping gauze lantern or Snow Peak or something of that nature, this would probably dwarf over it in size. But it's still a really neat lantern. You know, nowadays I do mostly car camping. I don't get out and hike as much as I do. And I usually tend to take battery operated lanterns because they're much more efficient than they used to be. But every once in a while, I like to have that nice glow that you can only get from a gas lantern. And this to me seems like it is the perfect size for that. But with all that being said, I'm going to go ahead, turn down the lights, and I'm going to turn this lantern on and let you take a look at it. And you can kind of make a decision on whether you like this or not. Okay guys, so I've mostly all the lights turned off in my studio and I'm going to go ahead and turn this on and give it just a little bit of gas and depress the piezo igniter button. With a little pop, we have a flame. Let me move this out of the way so it's not going to hurt my microphone there. Now this is probably on the minimum flame setting right here. And it's not a whole lot. You can turn it up a little bit more, which I'll go ahead and do right now. Of course, you get that nice sound that you always get off of a gas lantern. And that's really about as high up as it goes. But it's enough. And as you can see, it has a really nice golden glow off of it. And you just don't get that from a battery-operated lantern. I'll see if I can turn this down and how far I can. Now, what I did notice on this lantern as when it gets to around its lowest setting, it does tend to flame up a little bit. And if you've used the butane lanterns before, or the isobutane lanterns, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. And you tend to get a little bit of more of a rolling flame. Let's see here. So that's probably about as low as you can get it, which is pretty low. But anyway, that's how it works. And we're going to go ahead and get the lights back on. And I'm going to tell you what I think of this lantern. All right, guys, you've seen how it works. And you could definitely make a decision based on what I've shown you, of whether this is something you might want to have for yourself or not. To me, I am definitely going to keep this lantern. I really like it. It's not too big. It's not too small. It's just the right size. To me, it might be the Goldilocks of lanterns. So I have no intention of ever getting rid of it. And as far as Covia of a brand, I like to kind of stick to the made in the USA. I do like that. But this seems like a very solid brand. And I'm going to keep an eye on it from now on and kind of check back with them and see what they're up to. Anyway, this is Patrick from Uncle Bill's Camping. Thank you for taking the time to look at my video, and I will see you guys the next time around.
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please feel free to hit that subscribe or like button down below. You can also find me on Pinterest, Instagram, Facebook, UncleBillsCamping.com, here on YouTube, and vid.me. And from Uncle Bill's Camping, this is Patrick saying thank you for looking at my video.